This is the result of the final of the dresses that I was making in the fabric named Hum Aapke Dil Mein Rehte Hain. And now this dress I've just finished off, and I wanted to take it downstairs, but before I take it into the shop I thought I'll just show you what I've done with this. The hem, I've trimmed this with a printed fabric, and I've satined, I used the satin as the ribbon on the hemline. The neckline, which I showed earlier on how to do, is the stand-up collar type of neckline, like this, going around to the back. I've just pinned it on the back of the doll because it's a little bit wider there. Basically that's what the result looks like. Now there is, you probably noticed this, and there is a slight bit of unevenness at the bottom of the dress here, and really what happened was I actually was working quite late, and I accidentally went and snipped slightly bit onto one of the insides, so it's a slightly bit drooped effect on this, very marginal, but it is all the same there. That's one of the mistakes that I went and actually made. Now the fabric that I've used as the trim is off the roll, and I've just cut that to size, and I've used it like a lace. I've used it on the sides along here as well, and this is the boxed pleated type of dress. So it is like a frock type of dress. If I just show you the full result of this, oops, sorry about that. Now that is, I didn't actually want to wear this and show you because, I mean, I'm not the most, I felt like a bit of a kid in the other ones as well, to be honest. And that's basically what the end result looks like. Now, I've had a lot of people wooing the dresses that I've previously made, and they were so shocked and surprised that such a cheap fabric, what a stunning result it can achieve. So this one is actually quite similar, it's come out quite similar to a designer dress that we'd made that was in one of the catalogues. Even though, if I show you a little bit of a preview of that one and basically what that looks like, I don't think I've got it handy anywhere around here. So give me a minute and I'll show you what that one was like. On one of the shelves behind here. I'm not quite sure. Away quite high. Right, it's not quite handy for me to get down, but it. And that is one of these designer suits, and the one that we've created is actually quite similar to that. This is one that I have actually done for Halima, my daughter, and the style of these dresses, these are designer dresses, this is actually quite similar. I mean, it's the kind of similar result that you can achieve with a bit of imagination and your own designing and creation. So these come not as ready made, you still have to stitch them, but sort of the foundation is there, all the fabrics and all the pieces and trimmings and stuff you get to sort of make something like this. The beauty of fabric like this is that if you wear Oops. If you were to buy something like this, the only way that this is actually beneficial is really to actually purchase the fabric and then maybe, you know, go and source your trimmings and so on. Because if you are to actually order or some, you know, if you go and buy the laces and stuff, they are quite expensive and it works out quite expensive. The only beauty of suits like this is that these are custom made. These are made to the size of the individuals. So what you'll have is a custom made suit to your own size, which is a major problem if you're trying to actually buy something ready made and it doesn't fit you. So sometimes obviously the look of a customized garment is far more superior to anything you'll buy off the shelf at a ready made store. So that's something to bear in mind, but that's one of the new creations. Now I have actually quite a few new ideas and designs in mind, but being stuck for time, it's actually quite difficult to fit it in with my work schedule. So you will have to bear with me until I actually get time to do the next tutorial.